the mountain tops of uncharted ports and dilapidated.
You please catch my neck down.
2016 has been absolutely outstanding. Many indie developer budgets are now sizable and that's alongside number of people studios putting out games that don't require the financing of small islands. All of these factors can contribute to games that feel as though nowhere near enough people are playing them as they deserve, hence the level of underrated being applied to everything from the overlooked to the spirit of wrongly scored by music. I'm Scott from WhatCulture.com, and these are the 14 most criminally underrated video games of 2016 so far. Number 14, Hitman. Every month it's the same story for Hitman. I'll just wait for the full release, the top comment that comes on social media, only to be followed by SWAT tip fans doing their damnedest to convince the masses that the game is fantastic right now. Alas, I'm one of the latter. Hitman's episodic schedule is prepared that way to experience the game, and why? Because the levels are absolutely huge. The thing that none of us predicted when I even dragged your first announced this plan was that each month would come with its own set of unit kills. By releasing a large map and then pulling in elusive targets to face the front down and eliminate after main missions are done, it gives the game a unique dynamic feeling of challenge and community more than ever before. Overall, it adds an entirely new and refreshing dynamic to how we approach every map experience. Number 13, genuine innovations haven't been seen in first-person shooters on this since but with Superbad things you have to the time only moves when you do, a concept that makes it shine brighter than any other FPS I've played yet. During gameplay, time is slowed to the core. However, nudging mistakes like the forward will nudge you back into motion, with a full push speeding things up to your time. Once you get the hang of this momentum, you'll be dodging and moving around bullets, and pushing close heads clean off in one giant glare of pure wishful food. At the first time you start, Superbad plays back the progress in your time, so you always get an idea of how to slow down the time to the right bullet space in the control of the car. The fact that this game is initially put together as a glorified tech demo for a short convention is what will really blow you away. And number 12, Fury. Fury is hands down the most infuriating and downright challenging game of PS4 by quite some amount. What developers became there as a design team took the ground down to the best you can go. Your moveset is comprised of a split second parry, a quick dodge, some attack combos, and a short run side to the left. By combining all of the above,
Game to go to base in the hand. Palazzo. Light.